Hi everyone, it's your boy David from WeTweak. Welcome to Hammer Walkthrough. We're going to cover all the aspects and advantages of using Hammer for your kick creation. What is Hammer? Why did we create Hammer and for who it is? First of all, you gotta understand that Hammer, it's a kick engine and not any type of kick engine. It was created with the hard community, hard EDM, whatever it's hardcore music, hard style, or hard techno, with the idea of creating kicks in a most efficient way without using so many channels in your projects, having a better control and a whole better view in how you are merging your kicks together. So thanks to our community of professional artists and amateurs, you guys all give your opinion, your feedbacks and your suggestions that created the VST that I'm presenting you today, Hammer, the perfect kick layering engine to have full control over your kicks inside your DAW. So let's cover the first part, the overview on the interface. When you first open Hammer, this is what you get. You have an interface with a whole overview here, which is the main channel output that gives you the full visualization of all the layers together. Just to give you a quick example, if you change any volume of these layers, you will directly see the impact here on the visualization. The other wicked thing about it, it's the factory bank delivered with Hammer. You can enjoy more than 200 presets delivered in many genres, wherever you're working, old school kicks, raw kicks, even a few snares to give you an idea, techno, uptempo, hardcore, you name it. We try to cover every genre of hard music, and this is just the factory bank. A ton of new sounds are gonna come with the future update. Let's have a listen on the factory bank that you get when you purchase Hammer. Some nasty shit. The list is long and it really has a full spectrum in level of colors, timbres and type of kicks you can work inside Hammer. So on top of the factory bank of presets, we deliver you more than 300 sounds covering kick attacks, kick clicks, punches, subs and tails to just drag and drop inside Hammer to have the possibility to directly work on it and combine it with the factory banks or your own sounds. One of the cool parts around Hammer is also if you have a ton of sample packs in your hard drive sleeping, it's the time to give them a second life by just using them and combining them through layers with Hammer. Let's go back to the layering part. Why is it important and why do we need to layer? The wicked part of layering a kick is having the full control over the spectrum and how it sounds. That's why all your favorite artists have this method. When it comes to create that powerful kick, it is important to have full control wherever it's the punch, the tail of the subs, not only to avoid conflicting situations around the spectrum between the layers, but also to have a specific view on how it's merging together and how you can improve the sound of each layer independently without affecting the others. So that's why here we are presenting it under four layers. You can of course only use two, three, whatever you choose it. The idea here is to give you enough possibilities or enough space in the plugin for you to have the perfect control over your kick. So let's have a view on how you can use every channel independently and take advantage of it. So here you can see on channel one, the small view of the channel, and here add all the FX parameters, whether it's an EQ, a distortion, a bit crusher, and just walk through it and directly edit it. You can also directly see that whatever effects you apply, you can see it on the master overview of the kick. What is important to take in mind is when you add layers, most of them, if you don't really go choose a specific part of the kick, let's say that you want to take all the first parts of the kick, they're gonna have conflicts in level of frequencies together. So for this reason, you can independently adjust the equalization of each layers to avoid distortion in parts you don't want to have distortion. So for that, we have four layers, like I was talking about. For each of the layers, you can add EQs, distortion, Bitcrusher, Reverbe, and on top of having the possibility to customize all the channel effects for each layer, you have a master channel. It can give you that little extra makeup. For example, if you want to have some EQ on the master channel just to boost a little bit the lows of the whole layering ensemble. You can also, for example, just distort the shit out of it so you can get it a bit more crispy or a bit louder. You can save directly each FX separately for your next preset and adapt on every kick, you can just save it separately for each of them. So let's talk about the layer envelopes. For every channel, you have here a few possibilities in level of envelopes. Once you choose how much part of the kick you want to use, so let's put this part in solo, you can just play this part. Let's say that you just want to keep a little bit of the spectrum of this one. So you can isolate the spectrum. You can distort it. So let's go fat just to give you an idea. You can see it on the top output, how much it's affecting directly the sound. And on top of that, you can directly automate certain parameters, including distortion. For example, let's say that we want to have, let's say, a creative design around the distortion. So it will follow directly the envelope you're creating by selecting this parameter. You can do the same, for example, for volume. Here you can just do kind of a fade out, but you could choose to do a creative, let's say, drawing envelope that gives a specific sound and gives that rumble wave to the sound. You can do the same for the panning, which is not, let's say, what I would do for kicks, but there is a possibility, the pitch and the fine. For every channel, you have a few FX that can be added independently here and combined, but you also have the pre-delay that can be on or off, depending on what you want to use it for. In my case, I love this feature to create rumble kicks. So for example, you want this part of the kick to start layering time, you can use here the pre-delay that can be put in sync or not, and just choose, dependently on what you're doing, where you want it to start in time in your kick. Going back to the overview, you can directly see here in the channel, which is in solo now, the affectation of the envelope you added earlier. So here you have a minimized view of all the chain FX you applied that can be scrolled or saved. And you can go, of course, back to the main page by clicking here and having a better view around it. Including in the FX chain, the EQ is pretty simple and straightforward. You can also automate each of these parts and have a mix for the EQ or for the whole chain FX rack. In the distortion, including in the first version of Hammer, you have all these different distortions that all have a different timbre and color to the sound. Choose according to what you're looking for. For the reverb, you have the possibility to use the convolution reverb with, of course, a dry wet option, and you can also automate all the FX parameters in this reverb by clicking again in this little option. It can be applied to every aspect of the FX, and gives you more possibilities of creativity if you want to go crazy on your chain FX, whatever it's reverb, distortion, EQ, free of you to go crazy and find that perfect sound that fits to the rest of the layers. We try to have, let's say, the easiest approach in level of workflow. The idea is to give you a proper perspective in all the layers are working together. Or to use it, you can, like I was saying earlier, or you use the presets inside the main bank and just replace an element. Let's say that here you don't want to use this tail, but you do like the first two layers. You can just drag and drop here, adjust the part of the sound you want to use and see if it works with the rest. You can accordingly to the sound you choose, go to the FX and adapt it to the rest of the sound, which will affect directly the output overview of the frequency. So here is the first shot of the overview of Hammer. We are super excited to come up soon with a new update that will be more stable on Cubase. This is the really first version. We thank all our community for your help, feedbacks, and suggestions that will be applied directly on the next version. And if you have any ideas, just drop us a message. We will be happy to talk with you. See ya.